Creating a package.json file is one of the first steps in starting a Node.js project. You need a package.json file before you can install any dependencies from npm. The easiest way to create one is using the npm init command. In this tutorial, we'll create a package.json using npm init and walk through filling out common fields npm init prompts us for. We'll also look at the defaults suggested by npm init and how we can use them to automatically create a package.json file for us. Open your terminal and enter or create the folder for your project. I'm in a folder I created called Hey Node. Once you are in your folder, run npm init. npm init will prompt you to fill out some common package.json fields and then generate a package.json for you. After running the command, you'll see some help text and be prompted for a name for your package. Now, unless you intend to publish this package to the npm registry, none of these fields are strictly required. If you are publishing to npm, the name and version fields will be required. Otherwise, the only requirement of a package.json file is that it is valid JSON. Even though most of these fields are optional for a private project, the information in your package.json is very useful to other tools and developers. We recommend you fill out all the fields that you can when starting a new project. npm init will suggest some defaults based on information you can gather from the folder you ran npm init from. For the first field, package name, the name of the folder you're currently in will be suggested as the default name for the package, and you can either enter a different name or leave a blank and accept the default. I'm naming this package npm init example, and then I hit enter to accept. Next, we're prompted for the package version. npm init suggests version 1, and we can go ahead and accept that. If you publish your package to npm, the description field shows up in search results. You can leave this blank or briefly describe your project. The entry point is the file that is invoked when a consumer of your package loads the package with require. We can accept this default too. The test command is what you'd run to start your project's tests. We don't have any tests yet, and this can always be added later, so we'll accept the default of none. Next, we're asked for the Git repository for the project. If you already set up a Git repository in remote origin in the folder, the URL for the Git repository will be suggested for you. We haven't set up a repo yet, so we can leave this blank for now. Like the description field, the keywords field is used to help people find your package when searching on npmjs.com. It's a comma separated list of keywords that describes the project. Again though, if you're not going to publish your package to the npm registry, this isn't strictly required at all. The author field is a name, an email address, and optionally a website. Finally, we are prompted for a license. ISC is the default, but you can supply the short name of any other license. Or you can use unlicensed if the project is private and you don't want to attach a license at all. Let's instead choose the open source friendly ISC license here. Once you've completed all the prompts, a preview of the package.json will be shown. Press enter to accept and save the file. You should now see the package.json file in the folder. Congrats, you've created a package.json file. Now you can install dependencies if you want with npm install. As you probably noticed, we accepted a lot of the defaults or left fields blank. That's fine because, like we said, all fields are optional unless you're publishing to npm. If you want to create a default package.json so you can hurry up and install dependencies, we can tell npm init to accept all defaults by passing the dash dash yes flag, or dash y for short. This way, you don't have to sit through the prompts and hit enter repeatedly to accept the defaults. Passing the dash dash yes or dash y flag will accept all the defaults for you and generate the package automatically. So I'll delete the package.json we created and create a new one where we accept all the defaults. You're shown the package.json that it generated, and you can see that the file was created automatically and is in the folder that we're in currently. This is my preferred way of creating a package.json and helps you get a project going quickly and get you to a place where you can start installing dependencies. Once you've generated a package.json, you can always open it in your text editor and edit any information manually. Just make sure that the file is formatted as valid JSON, otherwise npm will throw errors at you. You can also always run npm init again to update an existing package.json. Let's update our package.json with a Git repository field. First, we need to actually initialize a Git repository in this project folder and add a remote origin. Once we've added the remote origin to the project, we can run npm init-y to update our existing package.json. You can see the repository field, as well as the bugs and homepage fields, have been added automatically based on the remote origin we added. npm init was able to infer those fields from the Git repository set up in our folder. npm init is additive. It won't overwrite values you have already entered, but it will add any fields that it can which were left blank. In this tutorial, we created a package.json file using npm init. We learned about some of the defaults npm init suggests when creating a package.json, and learned how to use those defaults to generate a package.json without answering any prompts. We also updated package.json with a repository field using npm init.